So we're looking at a matrix here, the one pictured right here in this region. And if you notice, this matrix has straight braces on the side of it. So the braces aren't exactly closed as we typically see in a matrix, like in this example here. So these straight braces actually mean something. The straight braces actually mean the determinant, okay? And so this right here in this area sets up the general rule for a determinant of a 2x2 matrix. Okay, in another video, we'll go ahead and take a look at determinants of other size matrices. But for now, we're going to settle with the 2x2 case. But first, let's talk about what the determinant is. I'm going to read this statement to you. It says, if a matrix is a square, meaning it has the same number of rows and the same number of columns, then we can assign to it a number called its determinant. Okay, so it's a determinant is just a number obtained from a matrix. Determinants can then be used to solve systems of linear equations and for determining if a matrix is invertible. So if a matrix has an inverse, then it must have a determinant. Okay? It must have a determinant that's not zero. I need to clarify. But that is a video for another time. So let's go ahead and take a look at the general pattern for finding a determinant. So if you see here, you take the elements A and you multiply it by D, and then B and you multiply it by C, and then you subtract. So in our case, we will have negative 7 times negative 7 minus negative 2 times 2. So let's go ahead and write that out. We'll have negative 7 times negative 7 minus negative 2 times 2. So in this case, I get 49 minus, and then over here, negative 2 times 2, negative 4. And 49 minus negative 4 actually becomes 49 plus 4. So the determinant of this matrix happens to be 53. So here is the determinant for this 2x2 matrix. So determinants are actually quite simple. It's a very simple calculation. And you can do this on most calculators, most graphing calculators that allow you to input a matrix. But in the 2x2 case, it's really simple. When you get beyond the 2x2, it becomes a little more complicated. All right, and just an important note again, that you can only find the determinant of a square matrix. So keep that in mind as well.